Ladies and gentlemen, I am honored to present this e-poster titled Place of Anticoagulation in the Association of Cerebral Vein Thrombosis and Chronic Subdural Hematoma. It's a case report and review of the literature. As we know, early diagnosis of cerebral vein thrombosis is crucial to prevent complications such as hydrocephalus, intracranial hypertension, and seizure. On the other hand, chronic subdural hematoma is a bleeding collected between the inner layer of the dura mater and the arachnoid. The association between these two situations can lead to a controversy because, as we know, anticoagulation is mandatory during cerebral vein thrombosis but can lead to worsening of the hematoma. This is the case of a 70-year-old man with a medical background of pulmonary tuberculosis who present with a progressive deterioration of his neurological status. Physical examination showed a Glasgow of 13 without any sign of localization. Brain CT scan, as you can see in figure number 1, showed a thrombosis of the left lateral sinus. The decision was to introduce anticoagulant, and few days later the patient presented a transitory improvement followed by a worsening. Another CT scan was performed, as you can see in figure number 2. It showed an hemispheric subdural hematoma without important mass effect. The decision was to maintain anticoagulation under narrow supervision. A control CT scan was performed days after, and as you can see in figure number 3, it showed the regression of both hematoma and thrombosis. Obviously, the association between cerebral vein thrombosis and subdural hematoma can lead to a controversy because, as we said, anticoagulation remains mandatory for the thrombosis but can worsen the second one. In the literature, no evident consensus has been proposed yet, but through the few reports we could obtain, all of them converge toward prescription of anticoagulation when radiologic features for the hematoma are not predicting clinical threat. Clinical course of most of the patients was uneventful, and most of them did not increase their bleeding. Clinical features related to the thrombosis also improved. In our case, the hematoma was delayed to the thrombosis. Few weeks of anticoagulation did not increase the volume of hematoma. However, there is no consensus about the duration of the treatment. To conclude, our report case adds to the limited literature on indication of anticoagulation treatment in the association of cerebral vein thrombosis and subdural hematoma. We should be aware of the indication and limitation of anticoagulant treatment, whose maintain preserve the hope for a most total possible recovery. Thank you for your attention.